Hello guys, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today I am going to discuss you about the OPAM application trainer. So OPAM is an operational amplifier. So it is a highly DC coupled amplifier. So for this OPAM application trainer, the order code for this training kit is 36328. So using this OPAM application trainer, we are going to see different application. So first of all, the first application of this OPAM application trainer is the voltage comparator circuit. Second one is zero crossing detector. Third one is phase shift oscillator. Fourth one is function generator generating square and triangular wave. Fifth one is half wave precision rectifier. Sixth is active second order high pass filter. The seventh is Wien bridge oscillator. 8th is Colpitt oscillator and 9th application is Hartley oscillator. So by one we are going to see different application of this OPAM application trainer. So first we start with this voltage comparator circuit. So our first experiment is to study and observe OPAM as a voltage comparator circuit. So this is the circuitry of voltage comparator circuit. So in this is a pictorial representation of voltage comparator circuit. In this circuitry, we have used two diodes to protect the voltage comparator circuit. So in this voltage comparator circuit, this is the voltage plus 15 volt is the supply voltage and minus 15 volt is the supply voltage. So on this reference voltage V, we are going to give voltage V1, and on this E input terminal voltage, we are going to give voltage V2. So this is the V non-inverting terminal and this is the V inverting terminal. So whenever the reference voltage, means the non-inverting terminal voltage, is greater than the inverting terminal voltage, means E input, the output is plus V saturation. Similarly, whenever the E input is greater than reference voltage, then output is minus V saturation. So for this experiment verification, we are going to use the CRO. So now I am going to perform some connection on this voltage comparator circuit. For example, here reference voltage I am taking a plus 9 volt and E input, means inverting terminal voltage, I am taking plus 5 volt, means V2 voltage. Here on, this is the plus 15 voltage supply voltage, we are going to give it to VCC, and minus 15 voltage is on minus 15 volt. Now I'm going to connect the CRO on the E0 terminal. So here I'm connecting the CRO on E0 terminal and the ground terminal of CRO to the ground, and take a one page code and connect this ground to the common. So once again I am going to verify the connection. First of all, connect the plus 15 volt to this 15 volt supply, minus 15 volt to minus 15 volt supply. And here I am taking the E reference voltage at plus 9 volt and E input voltage at plus 5 volt. So this is the connection. Now turn on the kit. So here you can observe on CRO, the output is showing plus V saturation. So this output is plus V saturation because we have taken the non-inverting terminal at plus 9 volt and inverting terminal at plus 5 volt. So you can see here non-inverting terminal voltage is greater than the inverting terminal voltage. It means the output is plus V saturation. Similarly, I am going to change the connection, interchange the two voltages. Now I am going to take reference voltage at plus 5 volt and E input terminal voltage plus 9 volt. So here you can see the output is minus V saturation. So it means I have taken the inverting terminal plus 9 volt and non-inverting terminal plus 5 volt, means the inverting terminal voltage is greater than non-inverting terminal voltage, so output is minus V saturation. So by using this voltage comparator circuit, we compare the two voltages. So this is the circuitry of and connection of voltage comparator circuit. So now we are moving on our next experiment to study and observe op-amp as a zero crossing detector circuit. So this is the in terminal of our zero crossing detector circuit. So on in terminal we are going to give sine wave, and this is the E out, means output terminal of zero crossing detector circuit. So on output we are going to see this square waveform with a duty cycle of 50%. So this is the pictorial diagram of zero crossing detector circuit, and this is the practical diagram of zero crossing detector circuit. So in this pictorial diagram we have used two diode in the circuitry to protect the circuit of zero crossing detector. So to perform this experiment of zero crossing detector circuit, I am going to perform some connection. So connect the plus 15 volt to plus 15 volt. So basically this circuit is similar to the voltage comparator circuit. Minus 15 volt to minus 15 volt. Now we are going to give input E in sine wave. Ground this function generator terminal using this COM port. Now connect the CRO on E0 terminal. And ground this ground terminal of zero crossing detector circuit. So these are the connection. Once again I am going to verify this connection. Connect the minus 15 volt to minus 15 volt, plus 15 volt to plus 15 volt, E input as a sine wave, ground the terminal of sine wave, and connect the CRO at E0 terminal. Now turn on the kit. So here you can see at output we are getting a square wave. So it have a duty cycle of 50%. So basically whenever the here we have taken non-inverting terminal grounded and inverting terminal at a variable sine wave. So whenever the inverting terminal is greater than non-inverting terminal, the output is minus V saturation. And whenever the non-inverting terminal is greater than inverting terminal, the output is plus V saturation. So from here, you can also vary the amplitude. So this is the output of zero crossing detector circuit. So here it is minus V saturation, plus V saturation. So this is the performance of zero crossing detector circuit. So now we are moving on our next experiment, that is to study and observe op-amp as a phase shift oscillator and its phase shift at every RC combination. So as we know, the one resistor and one capacitor can give a phase shift of 90 degree, but the combination of resistor and capacitor can give a phase shift of 180 degree. So this is the circuitry of phase shift oscillator. So as we know, the oscillator is a circuitry in which we convert the DC input into the AC output. So in AC we can also get a square wave or sine wave. So using this phase shift oscillator circuitry, we are going to observe the sine wave at output terminal. So to observe the output of this phase shift oscillator, we are going to connect the plus 15 volt to the power supply plus 15 volt, minus 15 volt to the power supply minus 15 volt. Here we do not have we don't need to connect this C2, C3, C4 because these are internally connected. Now connect the CRO at E0 terminal and ground the terminal of CRO using this common terminal. So as we know, the output of this phase shift oscillator is a sine wave with a phase shift of 180 degree. So to observe the output, turn on this kit so you can see in output we are getting a sine wave with a 180 degree phase shift. So this is the output of phase shift oscillator. Once again I am going to verify the connection. So plus 15 volt to plus 15 volt, minus 15 volt to minus 15 volt, and we do not need to connect the C2, C3, C4 because these are connected internally. And connect the CRO on E0 terminal and you are going to see output of sine wave. So this is all about the phase shift oscillator. Now we are moving on our next experiment to study and observe op-amp as a function generator. So generating square, triangular and sawtooth waveform. So for this experiment we are going to, so this is the, first of all this is the circuitry to generate the square, triangular and sawtooth waveform. So to generating these waveform I am going to perform some connection. So first of all connect the plus 15 volt supply to plus 15 volt of power supply, minus 15 volt to minus 15 volt of power supply. Now take the plus 15 volt from here to plus 15 volt here, the 74IC number 2, and minus 15 volt from IC1 of 741. So this is the connection of, so this is the connection to generate the different waveform. Now connect the CRO at the terminal E03 and ground of CRO to ground terminal and give this ground from here to common of power supply. So this is all about the connection. Now turn on the training kit. So on E03 output we having a square wave. So you can observe in the CRO we are getting the square wave. Now on E02 output we have again a square wave. So connect the CRO at this terminal. So you can see, similarly you can see on CRO we are having a square wave. Now change the CRO knob at E01 terminal. So at E01 terminal we are having a triangular waveform. So connect the CRO cable to E01 terminal. So on CRO you can observe a triangular waveform. Similarly On another terminal, we are also having a sawtooth waveform, so it may not be exact. So this is approximately, this is not the exact sawtooth waveform, but we can assume it is a sawtooth waveform. So this is all about this experiment of to generate different functions waveform. Now we are moving on our next experiment to study and observe op-amp as a half wave precision rectifier. So this is the circuit diagram of half wave rectifier. So this same circuit is printed on this training kit. So this is the circuitry of half wave precision rectifier. So as we know, the input of half wave precision rectifier is a sine wave, full sine wave. In output we are getting a negative part clipped sine wave. So this is the output of half wave precision rectifier. So to observe this output, I am going to perform some connection. So first of all, connect the plus 15 volt to plus 15 volt of power supply, minus 15 volt to minus 15 volt of power supply. So in rectifier circuit, we have to give the input of sine wave. Ground this sine wave generating terminal. Ground this terminal also using this common port. Now connect the CRO on E0 terminal. So here I am going to connect this CRO on E0 terminal and ground the CRO terminal ground to the from this common. So earlier I have said that in this half wave precision rectifier circuit we are going to give input as a sine wave. In output we observe the negative part of sine wave has to be clipped. So for observe this output, turn on this kit. So you can see here in output we are getting the clipped sine wave. So this is the output of half wave precision rectifier. Again I am going to verify some connection. Connect the plus 15 volt to plus 15 of power supply, minus 15 volt to minus 15 of power supply, input to the input generating sine wave, and connect the E0 and ground terminal of CRO to CRO. So this is all about this half wave precision rectifier. Now we are moving on our next experiment to study and observe op-amp as an active second order high pass filter. So this is the circuitry of active second order high pass filter and this is the frequency response for high pass filter. So initially for low frequency the high pass filter is blocked at frequencies and it only pass the higher frequency, but practically we have observed that after the frequency in megahertz the frequency response of high pass filter gain will start decreasing. So now we are going to observe the same thing in this training kit. So to observe the output of active second order high pass filter, connect the plus 15 volt to plus 15 volt of power supply, minus 15 volt to minus 15 volt of power supply. So at E input terminal we have to give sine wave as an input because we are going to block the and pass the frequency of different frequency of sine wave. Ground the sine wave generating terminal. Ground this terminal also using this COM and connect the CRO at E0 terminal. And ground this CRO ground to the from the common port. So this is all about the connection. Again I am going to verify the connection. Plus 15 volt to plus 15 volt of power supply, minus 15 volt to minus 15 volt of power supply, E input from output terminal of amplitude and ground the ground terminal of sine wave generating terminal and connect the CRO on E0 terminal. Now turn on the kit. So as we know what the active second order high pass filter does, that initially for lower frequencies it does not pass the frequencies and for higher frequencies it will going to pass the signal. So same thing we are going to observe using this training kit on CRO. So here initially I have given the frequency of 1 hertz. So 1 hertz frequency is very low frequency. So here the output of CRO is not passing any signal. So when I'm going to increase the frequency using this frequency selector, again at 10 hertz it is not passing the signal. So this is not a proper signal. Now again I am going to increase this frequency selector. So you can see at 100 hertz it is starting the passing the signal. So high pass filter will pass the higher frequency. So you can see here it passing the higher frequencies. Again I am increasing this frequency. So you can see here the peak to peak voltage means the gain of this output is constant for 100 hertz also, means 1 kilohertz also. Here I am increasing the frequency at 5 kilohertz, the gain remains same. Again at 6, 8, 9, 10, so gain continuously remaining same. But at the frequency of 1 megahertz, at 100 kilohertz, you can see the gain of this frequency response start decreasing. So practically I have earlier said that the for higher frequency the frequency response of active second order high pass filter will start decreasing. For some time it will remain constant of frequency band of 10 hertz to approximately 10 kilohertz, but after 10 kilohertz the frequency response of second order high pass filter start decreasing. So here the gain of second order high pass filter at the frequency of 100 kilohertz it will start decreasing. So this is all about the active second order high pass filter. So now we are moving on our next experiment to study and observe op-amp as a Wien bridge oscillator and its gain factor for a smooth sine wave. So to study this experiment, this is the Wien bridge oscillator circuit diagram and this is the procedure for this circuitry. So to verify the result of Wien bridge oscillator, we know in Wien bridge oscillator output we are going to get the sine wave output and using this potentiometer we are going to smooth the output of sine wave. So to see the output of this experiment. First of all, short the G and H terminal of Wien bridge oscillator and short the port terminal of 100K. Okay. Now connect the starting end of port terminal to the G terminal of Wien bridge oscillator and ending terminal of the port terminal on F terminal. So this is the connection to observe the sine wave on output. Now connect the CRO on E0 terminal and ground to the ground terminal. Now turn on the training kit. Sorry, here we do not given any supply. So connect the plus 15 volt to plus 15 volt and minus 15 volt to minus 15 volt. So that's my mistake. So using this port, we are going to smooth the sine wave. So here, by using this port of 100K, we are smoothing the sine wave. So this is the output of Wien bridge oscillator. Now, again, one by one, short the A and B terminal, C and D terminal. This is the D terminal. You can see here it is D terminal. Short the C and D terminal. Again turn on the kit. So you can see again you can smooth the sine wave using this port of 100K. So you can take different values of resistor and capacitor and you can smooth the sine wave on different values of resistor and capacitor. Similarly, you can short the terminal B and C and D and E and you can repeat same steps. So this is all about the Wien bridge oscillator. Now we are moving on our next experiment to examine the operation of Colpitt oscillator. So the Colpitt oscillator is a phase shift oscillator using inductor and tapped capacitor. Using an op-amp, the Colpitt oscillator circuit is given below. So this is the circuit diagram of Colpitt oscillator. So using this circuit, we are going to observe the output of sine wave. So to observe the output of sine wave or different frequency, we are going to vary the sine wave with different frequency using this inductance box. So to observe the output of Colpitt oscillator, first of all, connect the plus 15 volt to plus 15 volt, minus 15 volt to minus 15 volt, and make the port connection. So first of all, short these two terminal, starting end of port to this end of 100K port and the ending end of this port to the ending end of this port. Now here the C11 is 2.2 microfarad. This is internally connected and using this L1 and C10. We are going to vary capacitor and inductor value using this inductance box, and we are going to see the different sine wave of different frequencies. So to observe the output of Colpitt oscillator, first of all, connect the CRO on E0 terminal and make the C10 and L1 connection using this inductance box. So this is the inductance box section. So here decayed capacitance box. So here I am going to connect C10 terminal to this terminal and C10 ending terminal to this ending terminal. First of all, make them at zero position. Connect the inductance box to this both end of inductor. So here connect it to here, and last end of this inductance box to this inductor last end coil. So this is the connection of Colpitt oscillator. Now turn on the kit. So now on different values of capacitor and inductor, we are going to see the different frequencies sine wave. For example, here I have fixed the capacitance value at 3 microfarad, and now I am going to vary the inductor value. Sorry, here we have left one connection. Connect this ground terminal. Here it is a ground terminal. Connect this ground terminal to this common terminal. Now, initially I have set the value of capacitance at 3 microfarad, and I am going to vary the value of inductor. So here the value of inductor is 1 millihenry and the value of capacitance is 3 microfarad. So at 1 millihenry and 3 microfarad, we are getting the output sine wave of frequency 4.2 kilohertz. Now I am varying the value of capacitance. So here at 4 microfarad, value of capacitance, and at 2 millihenry value of inductor, we are getting the frequency of 2.79 kilohertz of sine wave. So similarly, you can vary the different values of capacitor and inductor, and you can observe the different frequencies sine wave in the output of Colpitt oscillator. Now we are moving on our next experiment to examine the operation of Hartley oscillator. So Hartley oscillator are the reactive complement for the Colpitt oscillator. Instead of two discrete capacitor, two discrete inductors are used in this Hartley oscillator. So this is the circuit diagram for Hartley oscillator. So now we know the output of oscillator is of sine wave or a square wave, but in the circuitry we are going to observe the output of sine wave. So this is the circuitry on panel of Hartley oscillator. So to see the output of Hartley oscillator, connect the plus 15 volt to plus 15 volt, minus 15 volt to minus 15 volt. Now make the port connection, short these two terminals. Connect the first end to first end of port and the second end to the second end of port. Now here the value of inductor L3 is fixed at 2 millihenry. Now I am going to take the different values of C12 and L2 using the decayed inductance box and decayed capacitance box. So to see the output of this Hartley oscillator, connect the CRO at E0 terminal of Hartley oscillator . Ground the terminal of CRO using the common of power supply. Now make the connection of inductance box to see the different frequencies sine wave using the capacitance and inductance box. So connect the capacitance box here and the last end of capacitance to this terminal. Similarly, connect the inductor here . So in Hartley oscillator we are going to vary the small values of inductor and capacitance to see the output of sine wave with a different frequency. So to observe the output, turn on this training kit. I have said that we are going to take small values of capacitance and inductance box. So here I am going to take the value of decayed capacitance box at 0.4 microfarad. Now I am going to verify this function generating section. So to verify this result, connect the CRO pin at the output and ground terminal and ground this CRO terminal using this common port. Turn on the training kit. So here the function generator, function selector is at sine wave. So you can see here on CRO we are getting a sine wave. As I am increasing the amplitude of sine wave, so you can see in output we are getting the peak to peak voltage of approximately 11 volt. Now I am going to select the different values, different waveform using function selector. So here you can see, here we are in on CRO, we are getting a triangular waveform with a peak to peak voltage of 10 volt. Similarly, using this function selector, we are getting a square waveform with a peak to peak voltage of 10 volt. You can also vary the frequencies. So you can see here, using this function selector, we can vary the frequencies, waveform, amplitude of waveform, etc. So this is all about the op-amp application trainer. So thank you for watching this video. For other queries, you can contact SK Technologies Private Limited. Thank you.